In this tutorial, we will be iterating on the previous fireworks effect we made in the last tutorial, which is linked in the description. We will be adding trails to our effect, learning how to use the Ribbon Renderer node, and learning how to add different types of textures to our particles. Ribbon renderers connect particles with continuous ribbons and map textures to them. They can be used to create fire, smoke, and light trails. More information on them can be found on the online documentation. The explosions of the fireworks are a bit distracting, so we will toggle them for now. There are also too many particles spawning, which will make it harder to see certain concepts later on. So, click the multiplier node in between the root event and the parent layer, then change the spawn count to 15. In order to create trails in our effect, we need something that triggers when they should be created, how often, and where. Because we want them to follow our parent particles, we need to create this trigger in that node graph. Go to the parent graph and create a trail node. The trail node is a template which is indicated by the red label in the upper left corner of the node. This node generates output events based on different properties that we will discuss later. For this node to work, you need to plug an input position. In this case, we will use the position of the parent particle, which is the physics position output pin. At this point, your graph might start to look a bit confusing since the links will get partially covered by nodes. In order to better organize this, you can right-click on a link and select Add Pass-Through. This creates a small joint in the link that can be moved out of the way of any nodes. Or, you can hover over the link you wish to move and press Shift-Alt. Click to release the joint. After you've done that, go back to your trail node and, as you can see, it outputs a signal event. You can create an output node from that event, and it will automatically be renamed Signal in the exported name field. We will change it to trails to keep everything organized. Now, when you go back to the root graph, you will see the trails output pin. Create and link another particle layer node and rename it to trail. Double-click this node and add a billboard renderer. You will see particles forming in the middle of the grid. We want our child particles to follow the path of the parent particles. In order to do that, we'll link a local position to world node to the billboard node, and the trail's position will get updated to follow the parents. The reason this happens is described in the documentation, but in this case, the local position to world node extracts information like position and orientation from the payload and uses that information to move the particles. In order to share the same color as the initial particles, go back to the parent graph, select the trail node, and then make the color property visible. Link the color pin to the color node. The trail node automatically creates event payloads for several different properties, so we don't have to. The name for the event payload color property is color. Now, go back to the trail particle graph, create an event parent node, and then create and link an event payload extract node. Rename the payload name to color and link it to the billboard. As you can see, each child particle now retrieves its parent's color. You can extract different properties added by the trail node, like the parent particle size, velocity, or custom payloads. In regards to performance, any unused payloads in an event will be removed from the effect once it is brought to the game engine. If you want to change the parameters of the trails, we can go back to the parent layer and select the trail node. In the properties panel, there are several parameters that can be adjusted. In the metric section, you can choose by which method your parameters affect the trails. You have different options that give different results. For example, if you were to pick distance as your spawn metric, and then change the spawn interval to 0.5, which controls how often particles are spawned, you can see that the particles are evenly spaced out. But if you change the spawn metric to time, you will see that the particles start out wider apart and spawn closer together as the parent particle slows down. Change the spawn interval to 0.2 and the spawn metric back to distance. It is important to note that all of these parameters are passed to the payload and in order to be used by the trail layer, must be extracted by using an event payload extract node. This is why if you change the size in the trail node, nothing happens. In order to change the size, you must go back to the billboard node in the trails layer. Change it to 0.1 so we can see the trails more clearly. Now, we will go through the second way in which trail particles can be displayed. add a ribbon renderer node, then link the local position to world node and the event payload extract color node. You will now see that the trail particles appear connected. You can also freely change the size parameter from the ribbon node. In order to have a better look at what is going on, slow down the simulation speed and then click the viewport and press F3 twice. This will render the particles as wireframes so that we can see what the particles are doing more clearly. As a side note, the F3 button changes the viewport's viewing mode. It cycles through normal, color and wireframe, wireframe, solid colors, and overdraw, which detects the density of particles. Pressing Shift F3 allows us to cycle backwards through the list. Cycle back to the wireframe viewing mode. Let's zoom into one of the trails and then pause the effect. You can see that the original trails we displayed with the billboard node are still there. The lines that are connected into one long chain are the particles displayed with the ribbon node. It creates one long chain of connected particles for each parent particle that is spawned. You can see this by the different colored chains, each belonging to a different parent particle. Currently, we have the particles being displayed by both a billboard node and a ribbon node. If you have to debug particles that are displayed by ribbon nodes, it is helpful because the billboard displays the location of the particles more clearly. We can now unpause the effect. We no longer need the billboard node, so we can delete it. It is important to understand that each one of the segments that creates a ribbon is its own particle. We can demonstrate this by adding a multiplier node in between the event payload extract color node and the ribbon node. Then, adding a random node and creating two floats. Change the view mode to color plus wireframe, and you will see that certain segments are brighter than others within one ribbon, rather than whole ribbons being brighter than other whole ribbons. You can delete the random nodes and go back to the normal viewing mode. We will add a fade as we did in the last tutorial, but in a different way. We will use the particle's life ratio to fade out the color. A particle life ratio is the normalized value of a particle's lifespan, starting with 0 when it is first spawned and ending with 1 when it dies. Add the self-life ratio node to the multiplier node, and you will see that the trails fade out. Except, they fade out in the opposite direction. This is because when a particle is first spawned, its life ratio value is 0, thus making the trail invisible. In order to flip this, we will add a 1 minus x node in between the self-life ratio node and the multiplier node. Now, the trails fade out in the correct direction. We will move on to adding textures to our trails. You can do this the same way that you add textures in a billboard node. Click the ribbon node, and in the properties panel, change the diffuse map. We chose a misrotated texture to demonstrate our next example. We want our texture to look like this, but currently it looks like this. You can see that the problem is one of the textures is oriented the correct way, while the other is not. You can fix this within the editor instead of recreating the texture. In the properties panel, enable texture UVs, and then scroll down and find the Texture UV section. From there, check the Rotate Texture box, and your texture should be oriented the correct way. With this type of texture, tiling it along the length of the ribbon looks fine because it's symmetrical. We will learn how to stretch non-symmetrical textures now. First, change the texture to the T-Debug texture located in the FX folder. This kind of texture has three different shapes on it as opposed to only one that we've seen before. We will learn how to cut up the texture, so instead of getting all three shapes, we only get one. First, we will enable the Atlas option. This will be covered in more detail in another video. For now, we will look at the several options for cutting up or subdividing the texture. We can see that the texture is split into four different squares, so we want a 2x2 subdivision. Now that the texture is cut up correctly, we need to tell the system which one of the squares we want to display. This is done by selecting the texture ID. The texture is numbered from 0, 1, 2, and 3 in this fashion. We want the arrow in this case, so we will input 1. Now, you should see tiled arrows following the parent particles. If they are not oriented the correct way, take the time to do this now. We only want one long arrow. In order to do this, we will select the Custom Texture U option, and in the node graph, we will see that a texture U pin appears on the ribbon node. This will allow us to customize how long we stretch our texture in the upwards direction. Because we only want the texture to stretch as long as the particle is alive, we will link a self-life ratio to the ribbon node. Now, you should see one long arrow as the trail. To finish off our effect, we can add a proper smoke texture to the trails. You can create this on your own. Then, we can go back to our root graph and untoggle the explosions. You can also change the spawn count mode back to 100 if you wish. That's all for this tutorial. Thanks for watching.